Occupy Wall Street movement's rightly been concerned about inequality, and we've had this enormous explosion of income at the top 1%. Well, finance is a very, very big part of that story. There's a lot of research on that that shows, you know, we know the 1% has pulled away. And, you know, there's research that looks at who are these 1%? Where are they getting their money? And, you know, some of these people are heads of corporations. Some of the people started corporations. You know, you'd have their Steve Jobs. You know, there's a few of those. But if you look at a single industry, what single industry produces the largest share of the people in 1%? Well, there's without a doubt, it's clearly finance. And, again, you're very hard-pressed. You look at the big winners in finance. These are people that are running hedge funds. They're very good at jumping in ahead of trades. They could see which way the market's going. Some of them have developed sophisticated computer algorithms. They could figure out when there's a big move on a stock or a commodity, and they jump ahead of everyone else. And by virtue of being in that market a few minutes or sometimes just a few seconds ahead of everyone else, you can make lots and lots of money. If you get it right most of the time, it's in some ways it's not all that different from insider trading. So if I'm insider trading and I find out, you know, Pfizer's got a new drug that's going to be really good for them, they'll make lots of money, or, you know, Exxon turns out that one of their wells went dry, you know, and that's going to be bad news for them. If I can get that information ahead of time and trade on that, well, that's, you know, that'll make me very rich. It's, of course, illegal, you know, but that would make me very rich. Well, a lot of what they do, a lot of what the hedge funds do, a lot of the successful traders, it basically has the same character. It might be legal, but it has the exact same character as insider trading. They're jumping in ahead of the deal. You know, they might have been very smart in being able to design a computer program that allows them to do it. But the point is it's pulling away wealth from the rest of society. It's not in any way creating wealth. It's simply siphoning away wealth that the rest of society produces.